In the world of UX, there are many prototyping tools available, ranging from digital platforms like Figma and Protopie to the classic pen and paper. The abundance of choices can be overwhelming. Here are five key factors to consider when choosing a tool. The most important factor to consider is the type of project you're working on and its goals. Some projects may not need digital tools, while others benefit from a combination of both paper and digital prototyping. If your focus primarily revolves around low to mid-fidelity prototypes, investing in advanced software may not be cost-effective depending on the software. A second factor to consider is cost. An important question to ask yourself is how much money am I willing to spend on a tool? This can depend on budget, team size, and type of project. Freelancers with limited budgets may opt for free or low-cost options, while larger corporate design teams may have more financial flexibility. Conducting price comparisons among top contenders can help you narrow down your choices. Next, evaluate the tool capabilities. Consider the fidelity and types of interactions required for testing your product or service. For instance, if multi-device interactions are a common feature in your projects, a tool like Protopie, designed for multi-device prototyping, may be a better fit. However, for static websites, simpler tools like Figma or Envision may suffice. When comparing tool capabilities, ask questions like, does this tool let me create effective prototypes that fit business goals? Do I need to be able to collaborate with a team? Are there certain integrations or plugins that I need? The fourth consideration is learnability and ease of use. This is crucial, especially when transitioning to a new tool within a team. Large teams means more individuals who need to learn the software. When comparing tools, ask yourself questions like, does this tool offer free educational resources or videos? Are these tools similar enough to my current tool to make a transition easy? While a learning curve is expected initially, educational resources should prevent long-term obstacles that could hinder productivity. You don't want to spend more time learning a tool than actually working in it. For those contemplating a tool change, a big factor to consider is stakeholder buy-in. The larger the team means the more people you'll have to convince. Engage with senior leadership, team members, developers to understand their needs and pain points regarding current software and potential software. If you think switching tools will improve productivity long-term, be prepared to address these pain points and propose solutions, particularly if securing stakeholder support is challenging. To summarize, consider project goals, cost, tool capabilities, learnability, and stakeholder buy-in collectively when determining the best tool for your needs. While selecting a tool varies for each individual or team, these five considerations can help streamline the decision-making process.
Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live, hands-on UX training.